welcome to the Gospel Light Minute X. This is Daniela Whyte, and we are glad that you have tuned in. Today, Daniel Whyte III is going to share with you, from a fresh and unique perspective, how you can get to know Jesus Christ for yourself. Daniel Whyte III is the national best-selling author of over 20 books. He has spoken in meetings across the United States and in over 25 foreign countries. He is the president of Gospel Light Society and Torch Ministries International. Now, here's your host, Daniel Whyte III.
Born again this way. This is the chief of sinners, Daniel Whyte III, president of Gospel Light Society International, reminding you what the Word of God says, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners like you and me. In 2011, superstar pop singer Lady Gaga produced a hit song titled Born This Way. In this song, she expresses to her legions of fans that she calls little monsters that the way they are is the way they were born, and that they cannot do anything to change it, nor do they need to try to change it. This song has been used to embolden young people who are homosexuals or who struggle with homosexuality. It subtly tells people who practice homosexuality that they were born this way, and that there is nothing they can do to change this behavior or lifestyle. Lady Gaga invokes God's name to support her view by saying, "I'm beautiful in my way, 'cause God makes no mistakes." In some ways, when applied to a more proper context, some of the lines to this song are true. God did not make any mistakes when He created us. For example, there are some things that show we were born this way and that we cannot change. For example, we cannot change where or how we were born. I was born in Brooklyn, New York. I cannot change that, at a little Jewish hospital. We cannot change who our parents are. I was born to Bishop and Mrs. Daniel Whyte, Jr. We cannot change our fingerprints. We cannot change our DNA or our skin color. However, just as there are things we cannot change, there are some things that we can change. We can change the way we behave. That's a fact. We can change our attitudes. We can even change our outlook. And we can change our sexual behavior. For example, if a person was a fornicator, as I was before I got saved, they can stop it. By the grace of God, I stopped being a fornicator after I met the Lord Jesus Christ. Before I was saved, I didn't even know what fornication meant. And no one ever took the time to tell me about it. In fact, I thought it was a sin not to fornicate. So no one is picking on anybody. No one is picking on homosexuals. The truth of the matter is we're all in the same boat. Now, I'm thankful to God I've never had the sin struggle with this thing called homosexuality. I don't even know how another man could be even interested in another ugly man. I am so taken up with how beautiful God made women that since I have been saved, that has been a constant struggle, the beauty of a woman. But be that as it may, by the grace of God, I am living proof. After 32 years of serving God and being married to one wife for 25 years, that your behavior can change and you can be a big part of that behavior changing, with God being the major part. If a person was an adulterer, they can stop. If a person was a fornicator, they can stop. If a person was a homosexual, they can stop that behavior as well. Because we're talking about sexuality. We're talking about behavior. If a person accepts Jesus Christ into their hearts, they can become born again this way. And God can help them to stop unproductive, ungodly behavior. We cannot change how we were born physically. I cannot change my beautiful brown eyes, nor would I try. But we can change once we are born again this way. In John 3, we are told of a certain man named Nicodemus, who came to Jesus at night seeking to know more about the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus told him in John 3:3, and by the way, Nicodemus was a good, moral, upright man. But Jesus told Nicodemus, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Jesus knew that Nicodemus could not do anything about his physical birth, but he could do something about his spiritual birth. He had to be born again this way, through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, who died on the cross for our sins, who shed his precious blood for our sins, became the Lamb that taketh away the sin of the world, according to John the Baptist. Like Nicodemus, I too had to be born again this way through the Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord Jesus Christ turned my life around, gave me a new mindset and a new outlook and a new purpose. Allow me to read a poem to you that describes a little bit of how I was born again. This poem is based upon the facts, and it was written by my oldest daughter for me, for this message. I gave my heart to Jesus on a blustery winter day. A man showed me Jesus loved me, and I was born again this way. I used to have no need for God, never mind what preachers say. But through the Bible, I saw the light, and I was born again this way. I could have continued on my sinful path, and if I did, I'd have to pay. But God's light shone down into my soul, and I was born again this way. You can give your heart to Jesus too, no matter if you're a liar, fornicator, or gay. All you must do is believe on him, and you can be born again this way. A dear friend of mine, all of us have sinned. We have all broken God's law. It makes no difference what the sin is, be it fornication, adultery, homosexuality, lying, cheating, dishonesty, rebelliousness, pride, and every wrong thing that we have ever done in life has separated us from God. Yes, you were born with a sinful nature, but you can be born again this way through Jesus Christ. Allow me to show you how. In this same passage of Scripture, where Nicodemus met with Jesus Christ, in John 3, Jesus didn't just tell Nicodemus that he had to be born again. He showed him how to be born again this way in John 3:16. It reads, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Born again this way. For God so loved the world, ladies and gentlemen, means that if you are in this world, God loves you. No matter what you have done, no matter who you have slept with or had sex with, it does not matter what sins you have committed or how messed up you are on the inside. God loves you more than you love yourself. God hates our abominations and our abominable behavior. And he tells us very clearly, people who are fornicators and adulterers and who are homosexuals and who are abominable will not go to heaven. People who live that kind of lifestyle will not be able to go to heaven. But if you trust Jesus Christ as your Savior, truly, the Lord Jesus Christ will come into your heart and save your soul, and your behavior will begin to change. God will help you with it. God loves you. Nicodemus was a sinner too, but God loved him. He was a good sinner, but he was a sinner, and God loved him. And God loves you too, that he gave his only begotten Son. His name is Jesus Christ, Emmanuel, God with us. He suffered, he bled, and he died on the cross for your sin. Somebody had to pay for your sin. Somebody had to go through your hell so that you could avoid going to hell. Jesus Christ died for your sins and for mine, and he was buried and rose again on the third day. Jesus Christ died for all sinners, all abominable people. The truth of the matter is all of us are perverted in some way. We are totally depraved, adulterers, cheaters, liars, homosexuals, murderers. Jesus Christ shed his blood on the cross so that all sins, whatever they are, can be covered once and for all. John the Baptist said, "Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world." Put your trust in Christ. Get under the blood of Jesus. There's power in the blood of Jesus, that whosoever believeth in him, the word whosoever means anybody, anybody at any time. Believeth in him means to trust him. Lady Gaga and all of your monsters, I'm talking to you, to depend upon him, to rely on him, or to have faith in him for your salvation. Lady Gaga and all of you little monsters, listen to me very well. I don't care who you are, where you are. You need to trust Jesus Christ for your soul salvation. You need to repent of your ungodly sins and ways. That's destroying your life and destroying your body. And you need to trust Jesus Christ as your Savior today, lest you drop off into hell at any moment. I don't care who you are. And by the way, don't you let any Christian tell you that you cannot be saved. You can be saved, but you cannot live your ungodly homosexual lifestyle once you get saved. That's a fact. Don't tell any church that you are not welcome, that you cannot come and trust Christ as Savior. Jesus Christ died for you too. And if you run across a bunch of Pharisees who don't want you and don't want you to visit their church, get saved and become a preacher and start your own church. Don't let hypocrites hinder you from coming to Christ. You say, I would get saved if all these Christian hypocrites were not in the church. Someone said one time that if you're letting a hypocrite keep you from Jesus, the hypocrite is closer to Jesus than you are. Don't worry about the hypocrite, the phony and the fake. You need to be willing to repent of your sins and trust Jesus Christ as your Savior. Rely on Him. Have faith in Him for your salvation. You are not required to do anything else but repent of your sins, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ to save you, and He'll save you. I want you to notice the next phrase, should not perish. Where? In hell, my friends. The Bible makes it very clear that all liars, all abominable people, and if you are committing homosexuality, the Bible says you are committing an abomination that makes you an abominable person. All adulterers also, all fornicators, all liars, all people who practice witchcraft and voodoo will die and go to hell, will be cast into the lake of fire if they do not put their faith and trust in the Lord Jesus Christ, who died on the cross and shed His blood on the cross for our sins. Nicodemus was on his way to hell before he met Jesus Christ, before he was born again this way. I was on my way to hell. In fact, I had told my friends I was going to drive the bus to hell. You're not listening to somebody who has not been lost. I have not been saved all of my life. I was the life of the party. Jam, jam, boogie, boogie. Let the good times roll. Let's party hard. Let's have all of the sex we can have, and let's drink as much liquor as we could drink, and let's get it on. Let's get this party started. That's Danny B before he was born again, before he was saved. That's who's talking to you today. So I know where you're coming from. I have not always been saved. And I'm here to tell you that once you truly accept Christ as Savior, He'll make all of the difference in your life. Yes, I was on my way to hell before I met the Lord Jesus Christ. December the 19th, 1979. I shall never forget it. But have everlasting life is the next phrase. But have everlasting life. Where? In heaven with God. That's where you want to go, dear friend. Nicodemus is in heaven today. I am going to heaven and will have everlasting life there because I believed in Jesus Christ and He saved me and He'll save you. You can do the same thing today. And let me tell you, there's no sex, no relationship worth dying and going to hell for. Think about it. Confess your sins, repent, and trust God. Trust Jesus Christ today for your salvation. Just believe on Jesus Christ and he will save you once and for all. He will deliver you from your past lifestyle and help you to live for him. The Bible also says in Romans 10:9-13, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Now, dear friend, if you are willing to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ for your salvation and to trust him to save you from hell, please pray with me the following simple prayer. Holy Father God, I realize that I am a sinner and that I have done some bad things in my life. For Jesus Christ's sake, please forgive me of my sins. I now believe with all of my heart that Jesus Christ, the Lord of glory, died for me on the cross. He shed his precious blood for my sins so that I could go free. He was buried and rose again. Lord Jesus, please come into my heart and save my soul and change my life today and forever. I thank you for saving me right now. Amen. Dear friend, if you prayed that prayer, if you trusted Christ as your Savior with me this morning or today or this evening, wherever you are, congratulations on doing the most important thing in life, and that is trusting Jesus Christ, the Lord of glory, as your Lord and Savior. I guarantee you he'll change your life. Things that you used to like, you won't like them no more, the old folks used to say. The places you used to go, you're not going to want to go after a while, I'm here to tell you. John 10:10 states, I am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly. Jesus Christ died so that you could live, and you have life more abundantly right now by being born again through Jesus Christ. Until we meet again, believe by faith, share the faith, and keep the faith. God bless you.
Thank you for listening to this Gospel Light Minute X broadcast. If you have questions about salvation, what to do after salvation, are looking for a good church home, or would like to read our pamphlet, What to Do After You Enter Through the Door, please visit www.gospellightsociety.com for more information. If you would like for us to pray for you, please send your prayer request to gls@gospellightsociety.com. This radio broadcast can be heard daily on BCNNRadio7.com, Buzzsprout.com, iTunes, Blog Talk Radio, and Live365. Tell your friends and family to tune in and discover God's amazing grace and love. Now here's a song that will encourage you in your newfound faith in Jesus Christ. God bless.
Him the best of everything that's left. living in fear, having trouble even looking at me. Wishing they would give you more than words, sick of people telling how it should be.